The path was really narrow now. The girls kept tripping up on the flax. Britt squeezed Ella's hand as Patu turned. Her chin was now level with his forehead, even though they were standing on flat ground. He seemed to be shrinking. His eyes, that had been almost black, were now a bluey brown. The ink on his skin had faded away, but the lines were still carved deep into his body. His feet barely touched the ground. He touched Ella's hand. His skin was ice cold. "Is it far to go?" Britt asked him in a shaky voice. "I want to get back soon." "You're trembling. It's okay. You're perfectly safe with me." His voice was very calm. "Lift your feet. That's right. Okay now. There's a little clearing just up ahead. You can catch your breath on a fallen log and look about. It's comfortable. The wood has been smoothed by years of bottoms like yours." Something crashed in the tree overhead. "Don't be scared. It's just a kookooper, our bush pigeon. The old people ate them. Very nice they were too. Not these days, no. The rules have changed. And this little dancer, hear it peep? Pee waka waka, the fantail. There was once a war between the land and seabirds, and these brave little fellas went into a frenzy and did a haka. Not as nice as they look. It's after the insects we've unsettled. It's hungry." The little birds squeaked and flickered around their heads. A log shifted on the fire with a crack. Sam jumped. Mum smiled down at him. "It's only a story, love."
"'Tis not," said Adam. "It really happened. Do you want to hear the end or not?"
Sam and I nodded together. Britt and Ella finally figured out that things weren't right. They wanted to run away, but they knew that he'd catch them. Patu was now fair-skinned, blue-eyed. His hair was red. His skin was smooth with no tattoos at all. His teeth glittered. He looked as short as a 10-year-old, and his face, though still very good-looking, now seemed very, very old.